It's the worst kept secret in the world. Thank you, TMZ.
Taylor Swift. She is living life in New York City. She's renting a new place for $40,000 a month.
It was built in 1912. It was originally a laundry and a place to store horses and carriages. I designed the house to have four bedrooms. It's got seven bathrooms. Despite the fact that it's a very long, narrow structure, it's about 106 feet long, about 22 feet wide. There are curves everywhere, and I wanted to kind of preserve that. Taylor Swift is a phenomenal tenant. Her people, her family, everybody completely respectful of the space. I guess the funniest part of that story is when she walked in, she said, "Ooh, it's so crusty." And I didn't know. I thought she hated the place and that was going to be that. But in Ms. Swift speak, that means she really loved the place. So much so, in fact, that she said, "I'd like to rent it, contents included." So glassware, towels, sheets, everything. She asked to leave and I just took my clothes and left. I think it impacted me in a weird way. I mean, I'm a pretty private person. One time I was actually running down the street. I was out for an afternoon run and a paparazzi literally pushed me into the street trying to get a picture of somebody going into my house. So it's kind of weird. Again, thanks to some of these crazy news programs, they dig and find facts and numbers, some of which are accurate, some of which aren't, and publish them everywhere. So other than the 600 new Facebook friends that I got from all over the world and the phone calls from radio DJs from Japan and all these other crazy things, in terms of the strategy for the property and what I always had in mind for the property, it really hasn't changed. It just created some chaos at the time.